Hello viewers, welcome once again to Elimu TV, which is your station where you watch and learn. And I'm your tutor, Mr. Mwangi Francis, and today we are going to look at structure of an atom, that is chemistry, form 2. Stay tuned throughout the lesson. So, have you ever wondered why chemical reactions take place? They take place in order for atoms to become stable. So, by the end of this lesson, we'll be able to have achieved the following objectives. So, objective number one during this lesson, we'll be able to define the term atom. We will recall what we said in Form 1, what is an atom, basically because we are looking at the structure of an atom. And then we'll go into details and look at we identify the subatomic particles, and then we state the characteristics of these subatomic particles, which gives us now the composition of the structure of an atom. So for us to get this better and into details, we understand that matter is anything that occupies space and has mass, anything. So this may range from bread, water, or even steam. State itself exists in three states: solid, for instance the blade, water, and steam, which gives us gas. Water, that is matter, exists in those three states. And this matter, since it's anything, it can be splitted or broken down to very small particles. The particles can be refined until we go to the last particle, the tiniest particle of matter. And this gives us that matter is made up of very tiny particles. The tiny particles are the ones which we refer to as atoms. You can see that we can subdivide, for instance, sodium hydroxide pellets until we go to the finer or the smallest particle, which we or ourselves we cannot be able even to divide. So basically, what is an atom? It is defined as the smallest particle of an element that can take part in a chemical reaction. And therefore, there is need for us also to remind ourselves of what is an element, which is the pure substance which cannot be split any further by any chemical means. So since now we know what is an atom, how does it look like? What is the structure of an atom? An atom basically is microscopic. That is, it can't be seen by our naked eyes. But it is made up of other tiny particles, which we refer to as subatomic particles. And here we have the nucleus, which is the center of the atom. And within the nucleus, you can see that we have two more particles, which we refer to as the proton and the neutron. So these two particles are basically referred to as nucleons because they are found within the nucleus. And we have an energy level, that is an area that surrounds the nucleus, where we have another particle which we refer to as an electron. An electron basically revolves. It is not static at one point. It revolves through this region, which we refer to as an energy level. So, an atom is made up of subatomic particles. These subatomic particles include proton, neutron, and electron. What are some of the properties of these subatomic particles? Proton, P, they are positively charged. Neutron, neutral, therefore they have no charge. But an electron has got a negative charge. In addition to that, we have more properties of these subatomic particles. What have we said about an electron? It is negatively charged. Its mass is negligible. That is, it could be 0.000. It's there, but it's negligible. That is, it's almost equivalent to zero. And it revolves around the nucleus in an area which we refer to as the energy level. And electrons are involved in chemical reactions. Those are the particles which take part in a chemical reaction. And we look at that later, chemical reactions. On the other hand, protons, they are positively charged. They have arbitrary mass unit of 1. Therefore, they have got mass. They are found within the nucleus. And they are involved in nuclear reactions. Nuclear energy, production of nuclear power. That we know that now it is involved, the protons within an atom take part. Down here we have a neutron. The word neutron, no charge, but they have or they play a very important role. They are found within the nucleus and they provide stability to the atom. They make the atom to be stable. So atoms of elements are different. We may have atoms of sodium. We may also have atoms of carbon. These are some of the elements. You can mention them. We have several. We have oxygen, nitrogen, phosphorus, chlorine, uranium is also another example of an element. Basically, this world is made up of elements. So many of them, we can't exhaust them. And these are elements. Each of these elements has its own specific composition of an atom. But it is the smallest particle of that element now which will take part in a chemical reaction. So the composition of an atom in the element in terms of the number of subatomic particles in an atom gives us the different types of elements that do exist. And these are atoms bond differently and therefore they give us different types of structures. And therefore the compounds formed also have got different properties. And that is basically the study of chemistry, study of the composition, structure, and the and the changes that matter undergoes. So, did we get the concept of this lesson? We can try to define now what is an atom. We state the subatomic particles, and at least we list down the characteristic of subatomic particles. So you can refer to student book 1, KLB, also Patel, but you can as well as refer more, or you can reach us through the contacts which is on your screen, reach us through an SMS, visit our Facebook or YouTube page, or you can as well as give us a tweet. Once again, Mr. Mwangi Francis, pay attention for the following lessons. Thank you.